How do you feel, Mikkel?
They outdid themselves for sure. I thought we were just coming in to like play a game, but this is like like a museum tour for the show. It's like a nerd's wet dream.
What's up, guys? It's the Normies, and we're back with some more Expanse content. Who would have thought? Guys, we had an incredible opportunity to go out to LA. We got invited to play the Expanse, a Telltale game, early. We got to play like the first hour, hour and a half of it, and we're going to talk about it in this video.
You were Dawes's attack dog, so you don't have any problems killing inners or belters who disagree with the OPA.
No, let me out.
I've heard quite a bit about you, Kamina Drummer. It's hard to tell if it's all true, though.
Truth is truth. How you deal with it is up to you, Boss Mang.
We also got a chance to meet and interview CARA G, and it was just incredible.
She's awesome.
Yeah, she's really cool, and we got to meet a lot of great people too, a lot of great influencers. It was an amazing weekend. We got to meet
like a hip hop gamer, if you're familiar, Angelica Trey, Sea Cat Wander, Kinda Funny Games, and even some reactors like Cat and Sunny and a funny little gal reacts. So like a lot of creators were invited to this event. It was a lot of fun.
This event was super wild, you guys. The minute you walked into it, it felt like you walked into a spaceship. You had two people waiting for your arrival with jumpsuits and really cool LED glasses. And then once you walk in closer to the event, into
the airlock,
you go through it. And like they had all the props up. They had the chair.
Authentic props from the show.
A bunch of authentic props. They had a bunch of desks set up with computers and Alienware for us.
So they really busted out the chops here. Down in brass tacks, the actual game. As y'all know, Telltale hasn't been around for a little while. You know the stories there. But they're back. This is their triumphant return. And they're actually partnering with Deck Nine Games. So Deck Nine did Life is Strange. We actually got to meet the voice actress, Kate Bentz.
Yeah, she plays Steph.
Yes.
It's so cool, dude. I was like, I just love how the closeness of that all is, a team and everything is there. So it was really exciting to see all of them there.
Like, this game is in good hands. If Telltale's coming back, trying to make an impression, they're partnering with Deck Nine Games. It's right up their alley.
And this is a brand new team. Like, this is the comeback of Telltale with, like, a brand new team, fresh faces, fresh ideas. And you can definitely tell.
You want to braid somebody's hair? Go find Maya. I'm busy.
Yeah, I'm Khan.
We're nearly there. The debris field is massive. It'll take me a minute to navigate.
All right, so already you really have to get in the mindset of all your crewmates because they're very different. And each of their communication styles are very different. A lot like being an actual leader.
And they're coming in strong.
Like, right off the bat, all the... If you're familiar with Telltale games, some of those glitchy pop-ins that would happen on that older engine they would used to run, I saw absolutely none of that here.
I'll monitor any data you send back, and I'll be here to patch anyone up, should it come to that.
The usual little glitches and pop-ins you're accustomed to in a Telltale game are non-existent here. Everything is pretty buttery smooth. Frame rate is consistent, and I haven't seen any pop-ins. I haven't seen anything like that.
The thing is, I really love that we're seeing Kara's story before what we know, where we first met her in Expanse. This is a prequel.
Character facial expressions are way more expressive now.
Just do your job. Okay.
Sure thing, boss man.
I think the facial reactions are way more expressive, lending more weight to your decisions. And even the smallest things you say, you're like, I shouldn't have said that. Every time. Every good decision narrative-based game makes you regret every decision you make.
We talked to Frost, who is one of the developers at Deck Nine.
What made you guys decide to go with the Expanse for Telltale's comeback?
So Telltale is known for kind of these gray area choices, and the Expanse is filled with those things. So, you know, I think there are members of the team that were huge Expanse nerds. And so talking about all these potential things, we wanted to look at, you know, the best that we could find out there. And, you know, in sci-fi, the Expanse is like amazing. Like if you look at their Rotten Tomatoes scores, they're insane. And for a good reason, they're great shows. So we wanted to make sure that we could have something that had a solid foundation, had great world building, and allowed us to jump in and create these really interesting moments for players so that they felt like they were playing an episode of The Expanse.
What was some criticism that you guys maybe faced in the past, and what was really important for you to absolutely just nail this time for the comeback?
Yeah, so I think things that were really important to us were stuff like the facial performance, right? We wanted to make sure that when we have someone like Kara G, who has this great range and ability, that comes through, right? You have to get this.
Otherwise, put this in your game.
But have to get the drummer face in. Because if you don't have that, then it feels less authentic to what the show is, right? And if our goal is to make something that feels like it's part of the universe, then you have to do that. So that is very important to us. Having mechanics like the zero-G exploration, very important to us, because it gets away from here's this small room that you click on a couple of things. It's like here's an entire area to explore, and you're floating and rotating and using mag boots to walk on the ceiling, and that you can still, it's not just gameplay for gameplay's sake, it is story, world building, putting you in the fantasy of being a deep space scavenger, and you're getting opinions from your crew, so you're getting to know these people better as you're clicking on these items and talking with them and getting to know it. Like that is, I think, very critical in everything that we do. Is storytelling really matters, and gameplay that helps tell a story is like a big focus for us.
The actual open world environment here, it's way more expansive than, say, like Walking Dead Telltale, where you're relegated to like Herschel's farm or something, like a small confined area where you have to do little mini games. Here, like, you're actually looting, you're a space pirate, you go around in zero G gravity, all this space wreckage around. It was pretty incredible to see this whole area is open to us. Like, it's huge.
And there's like debris floating everywhere. When you bump into it, it just bounces off the, like, it just feels like they really nailed the zero gravity feeling. Yeah. The most important thing for me was like, was this going to feel authentic to the Expanse, or was this just kind of like using the name? But no, you can tell like they're definitely fans. I mean, Kara G is very passionate about the Expanse.
We got the Baratna's gas jumpsuit. I mean, you can tell there's a lot of love for the show from this game. This isn't just like an Expanse game by name. Like, it feels authentic to the property.
Ty and Daniel weren't directly involved with this project, but they had their blessings. But Kara G did text them to consult. So like, It was cared for, and it is super authentic to the Expanse.
How involved were Ty and Daniel still with this project, if at all?
I don't think I told you this. He sent me an email a couple of weeks ago being like, I hope it was fun. I was like, yeah, it was rad.
It was great because I had to pitch to Kara, and I had to pitch to Ty and Daniel at separate times. And I can't tell you how nerve-wracking that is, by the way, to be like, hey, come up with a cool idea that you think is interesting. Also, the people that made it. You got to give that to them and make sure that they're on board with it. Crazy amount of pressure, but they're very humble guys. Like, they're very chill. And so coming in when I was talking about the story and where we wanted to go with it, they were going along with it and providing little bits here and there, like, you know, you could add this in here. I'm like, wow, that's freaking cool. So working with them was a great collaboration. And so we did that part. Then I had to pitch to her. And so this was...
And I am, I would say, not humble or cool.
Yeah. Neither of those things. So I'm like, great, what am I going to do?
I was like, who are you and what do you got?
Yeah. So yeah. I'm like, cool, this is a great way to start this meeting.
Yeah.
But we did this over Zoom. Like, I had to reach out to Carrie and her agent, and we set up some time. And I walked her through it like a D&D session. So the story that you were playing, I'm like, okay, here's the situation.
And I'm like, you're walking through. Like at my parents' house, sitting at their dining table. It's Christmas time. Yeah. I'm like, hi.
Yeah. But she was so nice throughout the whole thing. But I'm walking her through the story. And what was great was watching her reaction going like, oh, I don't know what I would do in that situation. And so there's having those torturous moments of, you know, what am I going to do? And seeing her go through it, I'm like, okay, she's in. Like, she's enjoying.
I was in.
So that was like, you know, after going through that whole thing, she was like, this is great. And so after that.
It was so fun.
If you don't know, she's the main character in this game. This is a drummer prequel game.
Yep.
You're on a ship called Artemis, and you are basically the captain of your crew. So unlike the other Telltale games where you kind of meet people along the way and forge relationships, there is already a dynamic going on here. And then you're kind of suddenly thrust into a leadership role where you have to figure out everyone's communication styles and like what it means to actually be a leader. And you kind of have to tailor your responses and things to what you think that person's like or what their personality is. And immediately, it's a cooler feeling because, you know, like being an actual captain of a spaceship, whether you're like Kirk or like fucking, I don't know, any of the other people in popular genres, like Holden even in the show. It's just a far different experience altogether because you're already a family unit.
It's a very intense experience off the bat. The decisions you have to make are crazy. You'll see in the future clips, I sat there for 10 minutes trying to make one decision.
I mean, we can kill him later, right? If I throw him to brick.
That's what they say, like everyone can die at any point.
They can die at any time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, but I look weak if I don't kill him. He's trying to kill me.
I don't know, okay.
Damn it.
But still.
Do I look weak in front of my team or do I save him for greater good possibly?
That's how hardcore they put you into the game with your other characters and everything. It's very emotional and very intense and I wish you all luck playing the game. But most of all, what I love about this is everything they mentioned, but they played us a pre-video of the staff talking about the game, and again, you can just see the love and passion for it.
Oh, man.
So you know this is just going to be amazing.
It's going to be awesome. I think it's going to do really well, and this is a prequel to the show, so it'll fit right in there with the story, and I'm just glad that we're getting more Expanse content. And you played a lot of the older Telltale games, like aside from the graphic upgrades and whatnot, like how did you feel like it controlled? Like
it was pretty similar with the controls, I will say, but with none of like that creakiness of that old engine. Like I will just say, like that engine really showed in the old Telltale games to which point like you just accepted when you saw pop-ins and glitches, like because it was just like, oh yeah, but like the story's great, just ignore the background like glitches. But there was absolutely none of that, like I said. And the openness, the open world of it was really like, it caught me off guard of like how big the areas were, looting and stuff. Like you could miss certain loot,
I love looting.
Like how it, like, yeah, it's looting the game.
Also, the
you can miss certain loot, and it kind of dictates what happens.
Yeah,
you
know what I mean?
You got to actually search around.
Also, the character movements, I will say, because in other Telltale games, you're just like walking forward or just like moving left to right. But in this game, you're actually in space. You actually have your boots that like space you to the floor if you need
the mag boots.
The mag boots, or you can
walk on the ceiling.
You're spinning in circles. You have to control that.
Oh!
I threw all of
them. Oh, I have mag boots. I can just walk up a wall. Yeah, as I'm getting used to the controls, it's like very fluid to like kind of go from a run into zero G, and then come back on and lock onto the floor. Walk up a wall. It feels really good.
It's like a lot to navigate, but easy, and they give you a lot of hints on how to do it.
Yeah, it's looting space. You're not just like looting the ground. You're walking on the wall. You're attaching your mag boots to the ceiling, checking the vents there. It's really neat, honestly.
Yeah.
It was amazing. I mean, it's probably one of the coolest things we've ever done. I mean, we were just nerding out. It was so awesome.
Immediately when it ended, I think we all were like,
no.
Oh,
that's but that was everybody around thing. Us, too. Everybody was like, no.
But it was an amazing weekend. I mean, they definitely treated us. It was nothing like we could have expected. And everybody's so cool and down to earth. You know, just shout out to people on the team. Frost, Jamie, Elizabeth, Darren.
Sam.
Matt, Sam. I mean, like
homie Darren. Just kept buying us beers.
Man. Darren is so cool, man. I love Darren, dude. And
I liked what I saw.
And on their website, they said there might be some DLC also, so it could be expanding even further. I'm so excited. We're definitely gonna stream it and check it out. You're gonna love it. I think it's gonna be.
If you're a fan of the show, you literally have to play it. So many creators there had not even heard of Expanse.
They were just like popular Twitch followers. So.
I was very surprised by that, but
we weren't even selected because we watched it. We were selected because we knew like basically, it was a sheer coincidence that we love The Expanse, have met the creators, have had a character named after Runa in the show, and we got to be invited to play the game, and it's fucking awesome, and if you're a fan, you have to play it.
Yeah, I'm glad, because I still think that The Expanse show is, like, grossly underrated. Like, it's so under the radar, so the fact that we're getting more content in a new medium that's a prequel to the show, I just think it's going to bring a lot of interest. Kara G is an amazing choice. Yeah, she's a
voice actress, man.
Really amazing choice to use her as a main character, because her performance is really strong, and she's just, like, really captivating as drummer. So
she sounds nothing like
drummer. She's so goofy.
I was actually hired as a guest star. Really? Yeah, so they're like, we're gonna like try to combine these characters from the books and see how it works. And I was like, oh, I want it to work.
It, like, if drummer's on this end of the spectrum, Kara G's like over here. Like, she's like nothing like drummer, but that's a testament to how good her acting is.
She's so fun.
And I'm excited that more people are gonna experience this world, and it's gonna like push people to the show, which might get us more content in the future to finish the third or the last three books.
Know,
you asked her. You asked her. The she last said, three. She books. Said Expanse for 100 years. She gave the Rick and Morty response.
She said, "Don't rule anything out." So,
but they're selling more props. So, like, yeah, look out for the auction, by the way. So,
yeah, no, actually, don't look out for the auction, because I want to buy everything. So, like, there's no auction. Don't worry about it.
Look out for this game coming out July 27th, yes. I believe. So it's a little bit of a ways away, but we'll tell you now. The first impressions, especially from like a pre-alpha version of the game, it was great. And if they're going to improve upon that, then I can't wait to see what the final product looks like.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
100% out of 10 for me, man. It was like, all of us were like, no, give us more. Why?
Yeah. Oh, God, it's so good. Yeah. Well, guys, you know, get ready.
Telltale's back.
Get ready for more Expanse and Telltale and Deck 9. It's just, it's all goodness and just awesomeness. And thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Bye.